why I care about air quality is because it's important to all of us. Although many people don't realize it, it affects everyone. And there are actually many detrimental effects that we don't realize ourselves.
I care about air quality because it impacts not only the way we live, but also how well our lives might be. A lot of that comes from health. I know a lot of friends who have asthma, who may have developed several problems due to bad air quality.
Air quality is a major concern for many people living in Los Angeles and other major cities around the country. Numerous studies and news articles are highlighting the major health risks, including asthma, heart disease, cancer, and even obesity associated with prolonged exposure to high levels of air pollution.
In my community, there's a freeway that runs right through it, the 10 freeway. So then, obviously, people who live right next to the freeway are exposed to more emissions than others because the cars and a train actually runs by every day. So they have to breathe in the air and it's more direct.
Many of the communities in Los Angeles County that we're working in rank in California's top 90th percentile of pollution burden, based on data from the 2014 CalEnviro screen. This is why APIOPA has been working over the past 3 years to engage and empower local youth to understand the impacts of air pollution and ways they can advocate for change. Last year, APIOPA was able to host Minister Wei Kuo Yen of the Taiwanese EPA at one of the local high schools we're working with, thanks to a partnership with the US EPA. Minister Wei's visit helped pave the way for APIOPA to build off of the air quality workshops that are already being done with schools in Taiwan and expand it to more schools in Los Angeles. The goal of these workshops is to educate youth across the United States, Taiwan, and eventually other countries around the world about air quality by utilizing low-cost air sensors to measure and understand how air pollution is impacting their communities.
I think air quality workshops are definitely an essential thing if you want to improve the quality of life in areas where there is pollution, because without knowledge about what's actually in the air, how can you improve it?
My little sister goes to school like right in the area where we were testing out the air quality and the noise pollution, and it brought up all these memories about the air quality and just like pollution in general. And for a while I stopped thinking about it, but when we went there and when we had to walk by my little sister's school, it just kind of brought up all that, and it kind of made me want to take an active step towards changing that.
Something I took away from the workshop was sometimes there are a lot of unintended consequences just from utilities that we find necessary that a lot of us don't really think about. Definitely the airplanes being located next to an airport, it was pretty eye-opening to realize that just some conveniences for us really affect other people in negative ways. So seeing alarming levels of particles in the air was pretty shocking.
The workshops we have are very important to the communities because you don't want to come along living this happy life and all of a sudden find out you have like lung problems because you've been living next to a freeway all your life and like not knowing about it. That you could have done something during that time to, you know, prevent it or at least decrease the possibility of, you know, getting some sickness.
These workshops are helping to inspire a new generation of youth to take action in their communities.
To have clean air, I think we should let the whole community know and have a way where, and think of a way where they can actually make a change. Because a lot of people in my community, sometimes they just like hear it and they know it's bad, but they don't know what to do about it.
There are many steps that we can take to have cleaner air. So first of all, we need to be aware of it. And I believe that if we work together, we can actually make a bigger change. But then there's also like many smaller steps that we can take, such as just carpooling or riding a bike as opposed to driving cars.
I believe that for us to see people actively like working towards making that change and to bring those people to like our communities, it's cool because it gives us a chance to learn about new things, things that we're not exposed to all the time, and you never know, it might spark that interest in someone to like pursue something like that, like as a career later on.
Making a concerted effort to talk to people, talk to the city council, talk to the city planner, talk to school board, talk to assembly members about our situation and trying to improve it.
Advocating is really important to really get people empowered and rallied up to, you know, actually make a difference in the community.